Oh, yeah. Thank you.
I don't know how, I'm almost going to cry. I don't know how in the world I met this man. But not a day goes by in my life where I am not quoting what he has taught me. Not a day. I am working with a company with 7,000 employees. And 90% of everything I teach them, 90% of everything I teach them is what I learned from him.
Oh.
You have the opportunity of a lifetime right now to learn from someone who is humble and understands lean at the highest level. So ask questions and be transformed. Ritsuo.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Paul. My name is Ritsuo Shingo. Myself with the introduction. I happen to be the son of Shigeo Shingo. That is just coincidence. And I joined Toyota 1970, quite a long time ago. And I pick up the several experiences about related to the working abroad. First, I joined Toyota Detroit office as a purchasing. And then from Detroit to Kentucky, I moved to Kentucky and joined the startup of Toyota Motor Kentucky as a purchasing. Then after TM UK, it's Toyota's first plant in UK. Then again startup, I joined as a purchasing. Then after the UK, I moved back to the Japan to join the China office, where Toyota, at that time, Toyota was not doing well, doing nothing about the China project. So we had two teams. One team was responsible for passenger car. Another team, which I was responsible for, the commercial vehicle. And my commercial vehicle project was approved beforehand of the passenger car project. So I established Sichuan Toyota China, and then I became the president of that company. And after that, I moved back to Toyota in Japan. Then at the time, Mr. Toyota, current president, was newly responsible for the China project. And I reported what I have done in China, and he requested me, as he was quite new to China project, please help him. So I started my reporting to Mr. Toyota at the time. Then after 1 year, I requested Mr. Toyota because my gemba was always in China, not in Japan. So always I was moving from Japan to China to do some work, which Mr. Toyota requested me to do. So I asked him, me getting old, very difficult to go to the China, fly to China every day. So please let me go to Beijing. So he said, yes, sure, you could go. Then I moved to Beijing. Then I, based upon his request, he wanted to do the Chinese project together with the other Toyota Group companies. Toyota Group companies, especially for car companies, Toyota, Hino, Daihatsu, three companies. But at that time, they worked independently. Each other, nothing, they knew each other. So Mr. Toyota requested me that we, the Toyota Group Company, should handle the China project together. So I tried to check the Daihatsu project in China, which they are not doing at all. And the Hino project, they were producing the buses in Shenyang province. Then I reported to him, their Shenyang project was very, very poor. Always great big deficit. And they didn't know how much deficit they have because they joined the project where already Chinese partners and Singapore and maybe five or six partners there. Then Hino joined. So Hino himself did not know how much deficit. Almost no one know, no partner in that project knew that how much big deficit they had. So I reported to Mr. Toyota, oh, Hino project was very, very poor. They are bankrupt. Then they should close the plant. Then he told me, don't tell Hino people, but he told me, oh, Hino, they didn't have any good person who could take care of the China project. So, Shingo-san, please join Hinomota. Oh, really? Should I go to the Hinomota? And yes, you should go. And please set up a certain project, help them. Then it was a very polite request. But for me, Mr. Toda told me that is he was very polite. But it is the kind of the order for me. So I said, yes, sure. But I didn't know what to do for Hino Mota. Then at that time, I knew Hino, Guanchi Mota people, they formed the joint venture with Honda. Very successful. They become rich. Then newly established joint venture with Toyota for passenger cars. Then could be very rich. And when I went to the Guanchi Motor to say hello, and I met with the one of the top executive, he's the president of the Guanchi Motor, and I said, Mr. Liu, thank you very much for your cooperation and help so far. I myself should move to Hino. Then he said, oh, that's very good, lucky. Because Guanchi Motor would like to set up joint venture with Hino to set up the truck business. And he mentioned to me, and I said to him, oh, kidding. Oh, you're crazy. You know, you got the Honda, became rich, fine. Toyota for passenger car, maybe could be rich again, but not truck. Truck business, very difficult to get profit. And moreover, there was the very strict rule by Chinese government. That is the M1, not the M category, that is the passenger category, only two cars for one group, like a Toyota group. And the N category, that is a commercial vehicle, again, two cars. Cars mean the two projects for Toyota groups. And passenger cars, already Toyota set up the joint venture with Ichimota, First Auto, in Tianjin. And then Guanchi Motor in Guangzhou, the passenger car. So second, two cars already gone. Then for the commercial vehicle, the one is the one which I established, Sichuan Toyota, China. This was a plant to produce Holster minibus. And central government told us that is passenger cars, but still it is the commercial vehicle project, so one card. And Hino in Shenyang, they were making buses. So already two cars were gone. So I told him, all right, the Guangxi Motor president, Mr. Liu, see, we have used all two cars for passenger cars, two cars for the commercial vehicle, so no more cars. It is not me, it is your government to restrict the project. If it became free to join, then we could do that. But only two are gone, so even for truck, we cannot do that. Please tell to the central government, not me. So I left his place, but as he strongly thought they need this project. I was wondering why in Guangzhou they need one more trucks, not good business. He said, city of Guangzhou, Guangzhou city government wanted to set the Guangzhou city as a Detroit of the United States, Detroit in China. At that time, maybe this time they don't say Detroit in China, but at that time they thought Detroit in China. That means both commercial vehicles, yes, they had a Honda, Toyota, okay. Then truck business. Then it is like a Detroit in Guangzhou. So that was the request. So I thought it over again and again and again. Maybe there might be some way. Then I found one way to make it possible. That was the Guangxi Motor joined the Shenyang project, and that makes Guangxi project. Then with the Guangxi project, we didn't have any commercial vehicle. So that could be the Shenyang project, could be the Guangxi Motors project. Then same company, Toyota Group, can establish the trucks business in Guangzhou. It is still using one card. That could be the only way. So I wrote that scheme and show it to Mr. Toyota. Mr. Toyota, this could be only one way to help Hino. No other way. When he took a look at my scheme, and he said to me, oh, very interesting. Please go ahead. Mr. Toyota say yes. That means Toyota Motor said yes, no problem. And Hino, I was responsible for it. So Hino, Toyota, no problem. Then I went to the central government and show my scheme. This could be against the central government policy or not. And the officer who are responsible for the project approval, authorization, saw my scheme and told me, oh, this could not be against our policy. And he asked me, please give me a copy of the scheme. Oh, sure, okay, give it to you. And he said, can I show this scheme to Guangxi people? At the time, the next people they are going to meet, it was the head of Guangxi. So he showed my scheme to Guangxi people. This could be the possibility. Then Guangxi people were very, very pleased. Then Guangxi top management, number one, called the number two, Mr. Liu, and Mr. Liu called me right away. In Chinese, I didn't understand, but through the interpreter, I got information. And he said, okay, Mr. Shingo, you proposed a very good scheme. And the central government said yes. And Guanchimota would like to proceed with the that project. They want to join the Shenyang project to share the one card. Then I right away I went to the Shenyang to discuss this matter with the partner, that is Shen Fei. Shen Fei is Shenyang airplane companies. They are manufacturing fighting jet. I was very, very surprised. They could not make any good buses which runs on the road. How come? How come they could make fighters? Were they really flying in the sky? No. But they are doing amazing. So I explained to the top of the Shen Fei, Shenyang firefighting, air jet company. Then he said, yes, they are very pleased that I will take the very rich company, Guanchi, to join the company, the joint venture. Then I went to the Shenyang government. All this government and company are together. City government is controlling any projects. Then the vice mayor of that Shenyang city told me, yes, please. He was very pleased because he knew that the Shenyang project was very, very poor. No profit at all. Big deficit. So he was very pleased. Oh, sorry, if I complete this story, still I'm self in touch. Then it will take more half an hour, so I should make it shorter, quicker. So, where am I? Ah, Sichuan, Toyota, China. Then Toyota Beijing office, as a representative. Then I became Toyota Hino Motors officer, as Mr. Toyota requested me to go over. Then I set up GAC, is Guanchi Motor, and Hino joint venture, which was approved by central government. Then I became the president of Guanchi Hino Motor. Then after returning from Guanchi Hino, Mr. Toyota requested me to go to the Toyota Technical Center. And then about two or three, about 3 years ago, I moved back to Japan. And then I became the president of the Institute of Management Improvement. And the company name, Institute of Management Improvement, is the not my own creation. It is my father, Ritsuo Shingo's organization name. Yeah, so I try to succeed his company name so that maybe someone in the United States might understand I'm the son of Ritsuo Shingo. So, and the other thing is I respected my father so much. So I wanted to succeed his organization name, like working together. So I became the president. But that is just one person, me only. It's not an organization. It's just me, one man.
Richie, so, can I ask one question?
Oh. Yes.
What was the number one thing you learned from your father?
Oh. I don't know it's a number one or two or three, but I've seen his back more than 30 years or 40 years. I've never seen him to have a rest. Why? Like a
never rest.
His jemba is it's a plant in most cases. So he should go out, take a look at plant, because plant will not come over to our house. So he should move to the plants. That means every once in a month, he return home to meet family. So I took him, I saw him every one day per month. So whenever he returned, he was working. He was working, he said to me, he was writing some books, so prepare his seminar, always working. So never have a rest. So I've seen him back. I clearly remember what I did with him is one day I play ping pong with him. One day. Second thing is the playing pool. Until then, I didn't know that he played the pool. No, not at all. But only one day. So 2 days, he spent with me. All right. But always I watched his back. That is the great thing I've learned. That's why I've never retired. No, I simply changed my job. I hate to use retirement. No, not at all. I work till I'm invited to the go to the heaven. Until then, I work like my father did. He passed away about 80 years and something. So I have more than 10 years to come to his age. So and he was working. Even in the hospital before he died, 2 or 3 days I was in the hospital to take a look at to see him. And I got a call from the publishment company. He was writing his book and asked me, "Oh, your son of Ritsuo Shingo, please ask your father how do they interpret his word, Tom, writing." So I said to the publishing company, "Oh, you're kidding. He'll be dying in 1 day or 2 days. You will do as you like." I couldn't ask my father what it means. He was about to die. Even after he passed away, I got a call from the a journalist from Italy or something in my house. I pick up phone. And I said, I'm Ritsuo Shingo. And he said, "Oh, could I make appointment with the Dr. Ritsuo Shingo? Sorry, he passed away." So until the last minute, he tried to work. And, Norman explained the very poor English of the first edition Green Book. He didn't know I did it. He thought my brother translated. Actually, I did. So one time when I met with him, Norman told me, I saw the Green Book and translated by me, but he didn't know me, my brother. Oh, that English was so poor. Sorry, it's my translation. He said my English ability at that time was very poor and right now become better, but not so much difference. So once my father tried to ask the translator to translate it into English, but he didn't know TPS at all. He couldn't understand any Japanese term, the meaning, then still try to write in English. So when I took a look at the draft, I thought, oh, he doesn't understand any content, concept of the TPS. So I told my father, very, very poor, because he was not so sure about the TPS. Then my father asked me to try to translate it again. Then I did. I had two good things. One is I know a little bit about the TPS, and the other thing is this is strongest point. That is my father. I could ask, what you really mean by this sentence? I can ask, but translator could not ask what it means. So very difficult. But for me, I can ask. So many times I call and ask, oh, this is what you mean. Then I, with the understanding, I try to write the English. Even in Japanese, very difficult for me to understand. So that's why I did. But it was, at the time I thought, oh, my English is not so good. But still, if I can communicate the message of his book, that is my purpose. It's not written in the beautiful English. No, not at all. If understandable, it's okay. Poor English or beautiful English doesn't matter. That is my feeling. But Norman-san told me very, very bad English, poor English. And he tried to rewrite the poor English to the beautiful, correct English.
I just want to
English.
Say, you know, it probably sold over 100,000 copies, number one. Over 100,000 copies from this pen. And it gave the Western world the Toyota production system. It came through Ritsuo.
So I made a little bit contribution why you are here. And one more contribution of me is let him go to the Western world. It was about 60 years old. He has never been to abroad at all. And I was the university student at the time. And I wanted to go to the United States using Greyhound. At the time, Greyhound has the 99 days, $99 campaign, round trip campaign. So I asked my father, please buy that round trip ticket. And he said, oh, okay. He bought me a ticket. And about 40 days or 50 days, I went around the United States alone, by using the Greyhound, almost all over the United States. And I returned to Japan, and he told me, oh, you made it alone. Why not me? My son made it to the United States alone, going around. Why not me? After that, he has decided to go to the United States abroad. So another contribution is I inspire him, motivate him to go abroad. Otherwise, he has never been. And I've heard quite often from him that he wanted to make sure whether his thought, idea, concept he made in Japan could be applicable to the another world, like the United States or Europe. That is his kind of curiosity. He went around and tried to make the improvement activity. And one more contribution is the naming of SMED. And when I translate that green book, I think there was a part of the SMED quick change. Then I again asked what the SMED means. It's not a SMED. Quick change in Japanese. Shinguru Dandori. Why is single? It is single. He started to play golf after 60 years old. Then he learned for the golf player, single means less than 10. That then less than 10 means 1 to 9. The handicap 1 to 9 is great. Then at that time, he tried to roll the single. That's why he named Shinguru Dandori in Japanese, single, naming from the golf player, less than 9 minutes. So I tried, oh, is that what you mean, single? Okay, then a single minute exchange of die. So in short, SMED. At that time, I didn't know that SMED could be used throughout the world. No idea at all. But now, even, I don't know whether I should say even, but even in China, they used SMED as a quick change. So that was another contribution, just naming only, SMED, my naming. And almost throughout the world, everybody is using SMED as a quick change. So, still self-introduction. Maybe almost half an hour. And as Mr. Toyoda requested me, Toyoda Technical Center, then I answered to him, I never experienced in the past of this kind of technical center. Technical center, it is technical center, but it's not technical center. No, it is the service training center that train the dealers are in the building where the dealers come and train, sales people of the Tenjin, Ichi Toyota, or Guanchi Toyota, train the dealers people there. So I didn't have any experience, and he said, don't care, or you have nothing to do with the technical center. You will do whatever you want, whatever I want. And he said, from the outside of Toyota, like in China, you will see any problems or improvement something, please let me know. That his request. Second one, he mentioned that he didn't like a monthly report at all. So I asked, you didn't like the monthly report? He said, no. And he told me, please write me a report every 10 days. So it became a great big burden for me. And he told me, please write me directly my report to Mr. Toyoda.
Why?
I don't know. I asked.
What was he trying to achieve?
Yeah, I asked, why directly report to you? There are a lot of directors, officers in China. There are a lot of people in between. Why I should write to him? He said, nuisance. Please directly report to me. So he wants some voices from Gemba. Nothing in between. So direct report every 10 days. I did every 10 days. Going around the dealers, find any problem, wrote report. Quality problem, wrote report. Every 10 days, I have decided to do a kind of the news reporter at Gemba. This is Mr. Shingo from Gemba. I report to you. So that's what I did.
And what did he say back to you? Did he reply back to you?
No, he didn't, in the beginning. He was president, very busy. So he told me, you wrote me a report, but I couldn't make any comment at all. Okay, it's a one way. No, he couldn't. But whenever I met with him, he told me that, yes, I'm reading your report. And actually, he made certain change after my report, I realized. So I thought, oh, he was actually reading my report. I make it simple, like one A4 page, or at the most two pages, mm-hmm. and simply, right, not the detail at all. He's a president, very busy. So simply write the point.
Can you tell us some of the problems that you were having? What were some of the biggest challenges you had in establishing?
It's a not challenge, but it is a kind of the problem. Problem means some dealers. Normally, they have a certain complaint, and they will not. They could not communicate with Toyota Fast Auto joint venture, the sales company, or Guanxi Motor joint venture. If they report to them, they are afraid of some bad reflection comes from them. So they are very afraid. So, but I explained to him, oh, I would not tell your name to those in between any organization in China. I would tell directly to Mr. Toyota. And moreover, I will not mention your company name at all. Just phenomena, so that he might understand and it might help him to improve the activity.
Did you feel like anonymity, making it anonymous, was critical?
Oh, I think several times, many things. One thing I reported is the quality problem, and I tried to communicate with him that we need to solve the problem as quick as possible. Otherwise, if you track the chain, like a dealer will report to the regional sales office, their engineer of Toyota, like a Guanxi Toyota. And that sales office report to like a Guanxi Toyota or Ichi Toyota, and Ichi Toyota report to the Beijing office, Toyota Beijing office, try to report to the Japan, not directly Mr. Toyota, no. So it's a long, long chain. So I try to shortcut everything from the Gemba to directly to Mr. Toyota. And he appreciated very much. And he changed many things. One big change is I think after my reading report, he thought the necessity of setting the organization to solve the quality problem, field problem. So they send, Toyota Japan send the people, QC engineers, quality engineers, to like a Guangzhou. They stayed at my office, and together with me, they work going around the market and report directly to the Japan engineering people. Normally, they use the normal path, it will take a long time to come over to China, not only China, anywhere, to take the TMC engineers, come to the place. Very long time, one month or 2 months. But after this organization came, when they report, for example, on Friday, we had some problem, please come to Guangzhou, then they send engineers from Japan right away. Friday, they reported. Next Monday, they sent. Amazing. Never happened for Toyota to do that. So I think what I did might contribute somewhat to Toyota Motor to improve the situation.
Ritsuo, so what advice do you have for us, that to shortcut everything? I mean, what's the takeaway? What do we learn from you right now that you did that worked so well? To write a report every 10 days?
No.
What do we learn?
I don't know. What you learn depends on you. But my message is top management should know what's happening in Gemba. Either directly or indirectly, it doesn't matter. But quick communication is very important. Otherwise, if it will take like a 1 month, no good.
Even so, layers.
No. So I think your organization is very quick. You're handing around the old plant and you know directly and you find the problem. So it's okay. But a big organization like Toyota, it'll be a very big problem. So anyway, top person should know Gemba. That and the message should be given to the top management right away. So when I was in Kentucky, we tell the our suppliers, not me, my boss told them, suppliers, all right, good news later, but bad news first. That is what my boss told the suppliers, but bad news first. So people don't like to tell the bad news, but bad news first. Good news later, okay. So good communication is the, I think, you need.
Have you noticed any difference between American workplace culture, Japanese workplace culture, Chinese workplace culture in delivering bad news? Like, culturally, are some areas more happy to give bad news?
I got a similar question. Any difference? Japanese and some other? No difference. No. You don't need to compare with the Japanese companies versus the American companies or Mexican companies or other companies. No, wherever you are, if not trained, or if you do not give the message, you mean the top management do not give the message, please tell me any bad thing right away. You don't need any solution, okay. Right away, if anything happens, please let me know. Most cases, people would like to solve. At least would like to clarify the problem and would like to guess certain the real causes and make improvement, then report to the top. Otherwise, they are scolded. That is the very common. But if you educate, if you communicate with those people, workers, middle management, everybody, please tell me the bad news first. Just simple fact is okay. No need to tell me the countermeasure at all. You don't need to tell me who are responsible for, no. Just tell me the simple story of the fact. Then, I think wherever you are, your people can do it. It is a matter of the attitude of the top management. For Toyota, it's not Toyota. For me, I tell the similar message to everybody. But generally speaking, Toyota is doing that way.
When you came and spoke with us, one of the things that I came away learning was how much time in your entire career you were on at the Gemba, on the floor, either with your vendors or with your people. And I just want to know, is it safe to say that half of your time was actually not in your office, but on the floor, traveling all around?
Yeah.
And is that something that Toyota taught you to do, or was it really something that you just did naturally?
So what I'm explaining is my experience. It is not the Toyota way, no. I'm not appropriate to tell the Toyota way. No, I don't know Toyota way. But my way. My way means the my experience. Each single person of Toyota, ex-Toyota workers, has the same experience. No. No. Everybody has a different, even a Toyota motor, different position and different work, so different. So I cannot simplify that I'm talking about Toyota way. No, not at all. Maybe George, he can explain the Toyota way. But not me. Not me. My experience only. Sorry, still self-introduction. So I reported to him more than 130 or something, every 10 days. When I've been to the dealers, when coming back on the car, I wrote the report. And when I returned to my office, I finished my report. Then I sent it to him. So I don't know the content is okay or not, but I completed my responsibility to write a report to him.
I'm going to ask a question real quick. How many people in here think that they have a direct line of communication that your people are telling you regularly?
I don't know. Oh, very good. Yeah.
80%.
Oh, very good.
I get a Friday report.
Yeah.
They just send me any personal issues, any financial issues, possibly getting collections on major accounts or anything like that. What else?
So you establish that on a weekly basis.
Yeah.
And you characterize that as tell me the bad news.
Yeah, they tell me the good and the bad. That's what I want it. It's bad. I want to know. Okay. I don't like unpleasant surprises. It irritates the crap out of me.
Anybody else and how do you do it? Go ahead.
Daily meeting, I love the daily meeting. We've got a green, yellow, red checklist for every department and they are reporting, self-reporting. A quick way to be able to tell. But I love the idea of tell me the bad news first.
Tell me the bad news. I haven't heard that
before. Yeah, I mean,
I like that a lot. Anybody else? Go ahead, Sherry.
I would say at our morning meeting we ask for exceptions. Anything that is wrong and it's not a blame game, it's just we want to know what's going wrong or when is something going in the ditch.
So daily on a daily basis, show me the problems. Anyone else?
There's also an interest in our organization where even the chairman of the company likes to know the bad news immediately, especially in two counts. One is on safety, second is on quality to do with the customers. Anything related to these two should be immediate from whatever level it is.
How often does he get that news? How often does he get that news? You're talking about Manu, right? How often does he get it? Once a day, do you think? Once a week?
Whenever it happens, there is no fixed frequency. If something happens today, it will be there within the next 1 hour, you will know.
Wow.
Yeah. If it is related to field complaint or something within a day, I would say, because by the time it
goes,
if it is safety, the information will go immediately.
How many did management establish it, or did Manu ask for that to happen? Who established that bad news?
No, it's a guideline set by him to us, which we also follow.
That's incredible.
How many people in the concept of not bringing it to me after you've got a solution? I do believe that 2000? I expect a solution to come with the problem too much. You know, the idea that come with me just with the news. Just with the news. Don't come to me after you've solved it.
I think it's profound.
It's profound, right?
It's profound.
Yeah. Well, you're saying just come to me with problems and then we'll talk about a solution later? Or you say come to me with a problem and then your solution?
What I hear Ritsuo saying is there needs to be immediate communication with management on problems. And don't even wait for the solution, just get the problem to them. Is that correct?
Yeah.
That's difficult. Quick.
Yeah.
Very
easy. Go ahead, Glenn.
So at SnapCab, we have these Gemba boards, and every day people write whatever the problems are up on the boards, and every day they get an audience to the entire management team, and we have a walk-around meeting, and they spend, you go twice a day or once a day?
It's one in the morning and one in the afternoon, two different areas of the company.
And you have the whole management team visits every part of the company, and then it's possible, before it gets into a big bureaucracy can try and solve the problem right then, and then we give, thanks to you, Paul, we give everybody time and materials every day to fix those problems.
I'm learning a whole lot right now.
I want to challenge everybody here for 1 second, because we're talking about problems, and problems, you have a countermeasure to problems you have to fix them. But how about if you think about normal versus abnormal? Because if people report abnormal things to their supervisor, it doesn't have to go right to the president or the highest level, but abnormal things can be averted that much faster that, you know, people start picking up on things as they change, because then you're not solving a big problem after, you're just kind of redirecting stuff. So don't lose sight of teaching people abnormal versus normal. Because if we focus in too much on problems, they might not report back that small thing that machine number one is making a little squeaky noise. Or, you know, that we're not getting this output. And it's not really a problem because people don't see that, but it's an abnormal condition that we're not doing the same, but it's not severe enough yet that I have to really say something. That's the key. Start having people dial in on that. That's where you get some real speed.
I just want to wait to see why report bad things to your superior.
You only have so much experience, and your superior obviously wants, when there's a problem, for you to figure out how to solve that problem. But for you to shoot in the dark for 10 years and come up with the wrong answer, when he already has that experience and can give guidance.
Well,
what I'm saying is,
when I say why,
I want people to be self-reliant, right? So why do you go to the board? Even though you're going to the boss to report negative things, in a certain way you're going and looking for permission from, approval from father or superior, instead of immediately solving the problem on your own. I just want you to think about that. The other thing, the most powerful thing that he's saying to me is, he said it before, or a year ago, Mr. Toyota said, when Ritsuo said, what am I going to do with this new institution that I'm setting up? And Mr. Toyota said, do whatever you want. Imagine that attitude that you have with your people working for you, that you tell them to do whatever you want. Thank you very much.
Please continue. Mr. Shingo, can I ask a question? So when you write these reports every 10 days,
and you're reporting all the bad news, are you...
Oh, no, not all the bad news, no.
Okay.
So I don't limit to the bad news,
okay.
But any news, he would like to know. So sometimes good news, because he is very busy. He never had a chance to visit the dealers at all. No, president, no way. So sometimes good news, which he was not realized. Oh, that's a good news for Toyota. Okay, we will do that activity to expand the good image of Toyota. Maybe okay. The bad news, okay. But 70% or 80% is the bad news. Because it's a complaint, basically a complaint from the top management of the dealers. And sometimes the quality problem. It is a complaint from the customer, users. So always.
So when you report it to him, though, is it as simple as you can possibly keep it? Like, just customer said this was an issue, or do you go into anything about, you know, we're going to try this, or we think it's because
as much as possible, I make certain comment, recommendation. But first thing I should tell him is tell him the fact, how the Toyota was viewed. Because almost all he didn't know. Dealer did not have any opportunity to talk to Mr. Toyota at all. He had the opportunity to talk to the Toyota people in the plant. Okay, but not directly to Mr. Toyota. So sorry, I had only 140 and still I've finished my self-introduction, and I pick up several things to tell you, and It's 12 o'clock. I should finish.
So I would say about maybe 10 minutes before 12.
Oh, okay. Then
just like that. You're not leaving us, though. You're coming having lunch with us.
Yeah.
You can talk at lunch. And then he's going to travel with us all day Tuesday also. So we have him for...
Yes, you can ask wherever you have opportunity. Fine. I try to explain. It is a very long history, so it's very difficult for me to talk to you, my experience, within like a 1 hour and 1:30. Okay, this is the topics I pick up when I try to analyze what happened. That is I have been in China from 1998 to 2012. And especially from 1998 to 2001, I became the president of Sichuan Toyota, as I explained. And the result of this joint venture was very, very successful. And I would like to review how I did to make it successful. This is my new experience to think, what was that? Why my project was successful? Because that was the first business year profit. It's a world record for Toyota. Normally Toyota thought certain project abroad 3 years, in 3 years the single year profit, in 5 years all are accumulative, all deficits are gone. So that is normal. But I said,
can you repeat that? After 3 years,
after 3 years you are single year profit, and after 5 years all investment deficit it was gone. That was the way we proposed to top management and get approval. Mm-hmm. So always we are saying, within 3 years we get the single year profit, 5 years all our deficits are gone. But never happened in Toyota Motor. No.
In 1 year.
In one year, I realized first business year, we got a profit. That was the world record for Toyota. Even in the domestic plant, I think that never happened.
Why?
So,
what happened?
Huh?
Why?
Why?
What did you do?
If I talk that. You should give me like a 1 day.
So
I try to pick up certain attitude which I used from now. There are a lot of things I did. One is cost reduction. The other one is big cost reduction using the competitive bidding. That gave a lot of reduction in cost. And buying the components from Japan was reduced. It's just a coincidence. It's a matter of the fluctuation of the exchange rate. But and the other one is the price. The price we studied was like 300,000 renminbi for the normal coaster, and 450,000 renminbi for the gorgeous coaster, two types. Then when I asked my accounting and the sales people that how about our plan before we started, and they said about 8 years we got a profit. 8 years? Too long. So normally our assignment was like 3 to 5 years. So So whatever we do, most effort, but we could not achieve any profitable year at all. They said, no, 8 years. So what about raising the price to 300,000 to the 350,000 and a gorgeous coaster like raised to the 500,000. It's a big increase. The answer was, no, Mr. Shingo. Yes, if we calculate, looks like better. But actually, we cannot sell at all. Too expensive. So I told them, okay, if we raise the price, if we cannot sell the car, don't worry, it's me to sell the car, the coaster. Then I did it. We couldn't sell as they proposed because it is quite expensive. So I started around to sell a car, and I drunk with the customers. They're doing the bottom-up campaign. And campaign in China, very dangerous. It's a white liquor. I couldn't drink at all. But it's a work to drink. So I said, campaign, oh, this is for my work. It is something I should do. So campaign. And their campaign is the real, they really mean in China. Drink up, campaign, and doing like this. See, nothing left. In Japan, don't worry. Even if you say campaign, you just sip a little bit, or don't drink, okay. But in China, no, not at all. You should very physically drink it up. So I got drunk every time. And I don't like to be back to the that joint venture in China to drink alcohol. No, not at all. But through that activity, about July, I went around to all dealers of the sales of the coaster. And in the end, I've never had a rest at all. No. Went around and having drinking, campaign, and ask them, please buy. And I will do whatever they want. So I help a lot to sell. And in the end, very fortunately, the higher grade, that makes a little bit profit. The lower grade does not make any profit at all. But the ratio of the higher grade and lower grade reversed. Higher grade, Chinese government, local government would like to buy. They like to buy the expensive one. Not try to save money. No, try to spend money. it's like a country money, people's money. But they like to buy expensive one. Don't buy the lower grade. So that's why in the end, the higher grade was sold more, like a 60% of total. The 40% for the lower grade. It was reversed. The general lower grade, 60%, 40% for the higher grade, but it reversed. So we got a profit. Sorry. 2 minutes. Next. Then, I've listed 4 or 5 of many stories, but today I couldn't touch upon. So only the one which I feel the important is the Gemba. Gemba Shuji, Gemba. Go and, not go and see, go and watch. This is the concept I used quite often, and that makes a great difference. Gemba used to mean the manufacturing plant at Toyota. But in my definition, Gemba means the place where actual things are happening. So it shouldn't be the manufacturing, the hospital, dealers, service, any place will do. You can pick up Gemba. So that is a big make big difference. And
can you explain the difference between go and see and go and watch?
Go and see is the I go to the plant and take a look at, and going to the next process, take a look at. No, for me, I go to watch, not see, go to watch, observe the process, like his plant. I sat
on the stool for hours.
And watch. Then, maybe this could be the problem to be solved. So I propose. This makes difference. I watched, observed, like 1 hour, sitting, then find a way.
And I want to interrupt you because I just have to tell this because it's so powerful. When I go to Kazakhstan, just walking around and just looking,
yeah,
I sit down in freezing cold weather, and all the other leaders are walking around like this with their hands in their pocket.
Yeah.
They don't know what they're doing, and I'm the only one sitting and watching. They're like, "What are you doing?" And I said, "He taught me how." Sit down.
Oh, really? Good.
And the more I sit and watch, the more I see.
Yeah, that's right.
I learned that lesson.
Oh, really? Thank you.
I'm always sitting and watching. They're going, "Why are you just sitting?" Because you can't see unless you sit there and study what's really going on.
Okay.
Thank you.
One minute.
One minute.
Just move.
He's the boss.
Move. Application. Hey. Move. Yeah, fighting it. This is another story. Okay, move. Quality problem at Chongqing. Hey, move. Show them your back. Okay, move. This is show them. Move. Oh, move. Never give up. This is another concept I use a lot. Give. Hey. Negotiation starts with no. So this is another concept. Okay. Do not blame the worker. This is very important. You are top management. So don't blame your workers. Blame yourself. If you blame your workers, it's like a spitting in the sky that will come onto your face. So don't blame your workers. Okay, next. Heart to heart. So you should associate with the people from the bottom of heart without expecting any result from them. Next. Conclusion. This is my conclusion. We cannot sell our Toyota car mentioned that we are using TPS. Nobody buys, no. And you will learn, digest, and apply to your case. You will create your own management system. If it is you to think and take action. This is the conclusion. Thank you very much. Hi, class. Thank you.
Thank you very much. How are you, Ritsuo? How was this morning?
Oh, very good, fine, I enjoyed. Thank you very much.
And what did you get the most? Was Paul asking too many questions?
Me? Always. Always.
And he always asks why. Why do you think that is?
Yeah. Yeah. Why? Yes, I know. I think the curiosity is something you should have. Otherwise, you will not ask why.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful.
Curiosity.